एवरीवन, इन द लास्ट सेशन वी हैव डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग दिस पर्टिकुलर टॉपोलॉजी. सो इन टुडेज सेशन वी विल डिस्कस हाउ वी कैन जनरेट AWK स्क्रिप्ट. ओके, सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग विद AWK स्क्रिप्ट, आई जस्ट वांट टू टेल यू रिगार्डिंग व्हाट इज द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ AWK स्क्रिप्ट. So as we have learned in the earlier session that whenever we are generating this type of topology in NS2, we can generate NAM file, and we have already generated the trace file also, right? But what happens in NAM file, we are only able to watch that particular topology, right? And based on that thing, we cannot be able to understand what is happening inside the network. What is happening with the packet, right? So for that we learn how to create trace file. Now after creating the trace file, we are able to understand what is happening with the packet. That means the packet is traveling from one end to the another, and now it is entered into the queue, now it is relieved from the queue, now it has been reached to the destination, right? So we can understand that kind of things with the help of trace file. But whenever we want to calculate something, that how many packets are delivered, how many packets are dropped, how many packets, what is the throughput of this particular topology. So to understand that kind of thing, to calculate that kind of parameters, we require the AWK script. Fine. So in the earlier session, we have created this type of topology. So in today's session, we are just going to change our code based on our requirement. Okay. So our requirement is to generate the AWK script for calculating the throughput. Fine. So for that, I will just open the terminal. Fine. In this terminal, we need to create a new file, and the extension of that file will be AWK. Okay. So over here, I am opening a new file. Let's say its name is throughput, because we want to calculate throughput with the help of this AWK script. Okay, fine. So this is our file. Now over here, as I have mentioned earlier, that this AWK script is divided in three parts. First part is a begin part, second part is a logic part, and third part is a ending part. So what is the difference and why this partition is there in this particular script? So in the begin part, what you can do, you can define your different variables which you are going to use throughout this practical, right? Throughout this script. So that should be mentioned in the begin part. Now second part is a logic part. So in that particular thing, what happens, whatever the main logic you want to apply, for example, right now we are writing the script to find out the throughput, right? So for throughput, whatever the logic we want to apply, that will be in a logic part. And this is a one kind of loop. That means whatever, how many lines are there in your TR file, that loop will run for each and every row which are there in your TR file, that is the trace file. Okay, so that is why that is the second section is a loop or logic building. And lastly, the third part is the ending part. That means whatever the calculation we want to do at the end of all the looping, we can do the calculation in the ending part, and we can print that thing in our terminal. Fine. So these are the three types. So first of all, we will begin with the first part, that is the begin part. So we need to write begin like this in a capital letter, right? After that, let's say we require some variables like start time. We should have knowledge regarding the start time. Then what is the finish time? Okay, so we require S time and F time. So in this AWK script, there is no need to write semicolon after declaring any variable. Okay, so here to mention that this statement is completed, there is no requirement of semicolons in same as your C language. Matlab in C language, you are adding the semicolon in the end to indicate that the statement has been completed, right? So instead of that, here we are just writing the new variable in a new new line, so that we can differentiate that this statement has been completed, right? Now then we required flag, okay. Then we also required the what is the file size, because to calculate throughput we required how many packets are transferred from one end to the another end. So whatever the size of packets, we need to calculate that packet total size, fine, so that we can be able to get the whole message size, file size, fine. After that we required one for throughput. Okay, so over here I am writing throughput, and we need to also calculate the latency. Now what is this latency? Latency means the time duration taken by a packet from to reach the destination from the sender side, right? So for that we need to just calculate the finish time minus start time, right? So that is your latency. Okay, so that's it from the begin part. So I am ending this. Now what we require, we require the logic part, loop part. So for looping there will be the opening bracket only, okay. So whatever we are going to write between these two curly braces, that will be run for the multiple times. So that multiple times depends on your trace file. So how many lines are there in your trace file, that means the rows, number of rows you are having your trace file, that at that many times this loop will run, okay. So over here now we will put our conditions. So what we want to do, so over here we will write that if $1 equals to R. Now the question arises that what is $1 and what is R, okay. So as we have learned that our trace file format, so in the trace file format one represents, the first column is your event, right? So over here your $1 represents the first field of your trace file. So we are telling that the first field of your trace file should be R, must be R, equals R. That means if the whatever the packet is there in our first row, the event is equals to R, then we will do some task. And one more thing we need to add, that is the destination, because we want to calculate the throughput, okay. What is the throughput of this particular destination, right? So for that we required over here, we will write and $4 equals to 4, fine. So now what does this mean? This means that $4, that means 1, 2, 3 and 4, 4 represents 2 node, that means destination node. So destination node should be number 4, that means node 4, and node 4, that means this one. That means whatever we are calculating, the throughput we are calculating, that is for the TCP connection, fine. So over here I have written $4 equals to 4, and if that particular row satisfies this condition, that what we will do, we will just simply add the file size, okay. So over here I will write the shorthand operator plus equals to, and that is file size $6. Now $6 represents our packet size, so packet size is equals to that means whatever the time the loop will run, at that time we will add this packet size each and every time into this particular file size, okay. That value will be stored in a file size, so we will be able to get the whole message length, right. Then again I will put one condition, if flag equals to 0, right, because initial condition the flag will be the 0, then what we will do, we will do start time equals to $2, fine. So $2 represents the time, okay. So we are entering the time over here, fine. Then after this, one more thing we need to say, that flag equals to 1. We need to change the value of flag. Then what we need to do, we need to add the finish time, because we have already given the start time. So what is the finish time? The finish time will be So over here we need to just close this, right? So this if is opening over here, closing over here, opening over here, closing over here, and this is the your loop, fine. So as we have entered our looping or logic part, now we will enter our ending part. So for that we need to write END and in a capital letter. So first of all, we have to generate the latency, because we need to use this latency while calculating the throughput. So first of all, we will calculate the latency. Okay, so latency equals to, as I have mentioned earlier, that is the finish time minus start time, right? Then now we want to generate the throughput. The throughput is equals to file size into 8. Now why we are doing into 8? Because your file size is having enough bytes, so we need to convert that bytes into bits, right? And after that we need to just divide it with the help of latency. Okay, now simply what we will do, we will just simply printf, same as your C language. Okay, so printf, what we want to print, that is let's say latency. Okay, and we will write percentage f, right, in a point value, that is latency. Okay, similarly we will print f, okay, f, that is true. Fine. So we have completed. So we will close this curly braces. Okay, so we have generated our AWK script over here. Now what is our next step? Our next step is to just link this AWK script with tr file, because whatever the inputs we are giving, that is based on your TRS file, right? So for linking both the thing, we will link these two things in our TCL file. Okay, so I will just open our earlier TCL script, right? So in this particular TCL script, what you need to change is, you just need to add one line over here whenever we are calling this finish procedure. Now in this finish procedure, what you need to do, you need to say that we want to execute what AWK script, right? In that we want to add file, which file? So thru throughput dot awk throughput file, and we want to add, we want to give as an input, that is the prec2.tr file, and then you need to exit. Fine. So for linking, you need to add this one line in your TCL script. So we will save this, close this, and now we will simply run prec2.tcl. So you can see that here is your latency and here is your throughput for the TCP connection. Okay, so thus we can use AWK script for such kind of calculation of our networking parameters, right? So based on these things, we can be able to identify, we can be able to analyze that whether whatever the topology we have created, that is perfect or not. Is there any changes required or not, right? Same, in the same manner, you can also calculate how many packets are dropping, how many, what is the packet delivery ratio, what is the total packets, right? So that kind of stuff can you, you can also do with the help of this AWK script. In this particular thing, if you want to check the throughput for both the things, that means for your for TCP and UDP both, then you can also do that kind of thing also. You just need to enter that many kind of variables and do the same procedure, so you can add this for the UDP also. And for that you just need to change one or two thing, that is the destination, right? So destination should be 5 over here for the UDP, right? So for UDP, let me show you this thing. So for that, this many things will remain same for the UDP also, right? So if you want to add that kind of thing, so we will just simply copy and paste, and we will add to differentiate, we will just add some parameters after this, right? So this is the new variables which we have defined for the UDP. Fine, the looping will be same, right? So for that we just need to copy this thing, copy, and then we need to just paste it. So in this, what we need to change is, we need to change that if the event is equals to receive, so destination node should be 5. Okay, all other stuff will remain same. You need to just change the variable name over here. All other thing will remain same. Fine. So over here you have created the loop for logic for the UDP also, and then you just need to change, you just need to copy this thing and simply paste. Now let me see, one over here, 1 and 1, right? This is of ECP connection, this is also of ACP connection, this one is also of UDP connection, and this one is also of your UDP connection. Fine. So now we will save this and simply we will run our practical 2. So over here you can see that the latency of TCP is this one, and for the UDP connection is this one, right? So in the same manner you can calculate different parameters of networking, right? And in this practical, if you want to if you don't want to watch the topology, that NAM part, so you can also delete that part. That does not make any change in your particular practical, right? So over here, if you want to change this, if you will delete it, then also it will run perfectly fine. There is no need of this to perform AWK script. Fine. So let me show you. Right? It works perfectly fine. So that NAM part is only for the to watch the topology. Trace file is to trace each and everything, and AWK script is for to calculate networking parameters like throughput, latency, delivery ratio, packet, total packets, and all other stuffs. Thank you.